Good morning. I am Professor Christine Kanderas. As the faculty marshal, it is my privilege to declare that the 121st Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts commencement ceremony is now in order. On behalf of the faculty at MCLA, it is my distinct honor to bring congratulations and greetings to the graduates here today. We are proud of all of your achievements. It is my pleasure to introduce and welcome Elizabeth Rodeo, who will sing the national anthem. Elizabeth is accompanied by Matthew Thomas.
Good morning. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts, I am honored to convene today's 121st commencement exercises. I'm delighted to preside over today's exercises as the 12th president of MCLA and to welcome family members, faculty, staff, alumni, friends, and distinguished guests on this special day. And of course, welcome and congratulations to the class of 2020. During the spring of 2020, you faced unprecedented challenges and rose to the occasion with grace and determination. Commencement is the culmination of years of academic work and accomplishments of our graduates. During your time at MCLA, you have compiled a long list of accomplishments and inspired us with your success in the classroom, in the lab, on the stage, in the gallery, on the athletic fields and courts, and in the community. You have studied abroad, conducted research, participated in service trips and internships, and created community service programs to meet the needs of our communities. You were inducted into the honor societies, held offices in student government, produced works of art, theater, dance, and spoken word, scored goals, runs and baskets, and crossed the finish lines. Some of our graduates returned to school after time off, bringing with them professional and life experiences that enriched class discussions and that underscored the importance of lifelong learning. Graduates who have fulfilled the requirements of a master's degree in education or a certificate of advanced graduate study have devoted themselves to changing the lives of students through the power of education. MBA graduates have balanced work while attending class on weekends and online to become better leaders and managers. Many of you worked full-time or multiple part-time jobs while you pursued your degree. Some of you are parents, step-parents, and foster parents raising families, or caring for parents and grandparents, and you completed your education while balancing a plethora of responsibilities. You have set an example for all of us and have made your families and all of us at MCLA proud. Today, we celebrate all of you, and we are grateful for the time we had with you. At a small college like ours, we have the good fortune to get to know our students, and they get to know us. There are many people who've contributed in special ways to the accomplishments of our graduates, especially the faculty and staff at MCLA. They care deeply about their work and take a personal interest in the educational experiences and well-being of our students. My colleagues and I are called to our work at MCLA by one common purpose. We want to contribute to the education of the next generation of leaders. Because of that, our faculty give of their time and expertise generously and without hesitation as we continue to build and shape the future of MCLA and public higher education. Our dedicated staff and administrators work in partnership with the faculty. No matter their role or assignment, our staff members go above and beyond to make MCLA a place where students can achieve powerful results. They serve the college with distinction, and their commitment to our students, our community, and one another is inspiring. Speaking for the faculty and staff of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts, it is our sincere hope that we have done well by you, and that your education has prepared you for a lifetime of possibilities. It is our further hope that as you leave here, you do so with a greater understanding of yourself and of the world. I invite the faculty, administrators, and staff to please join us following today's exercises for a Zoom meeting so that graduates and their families and friends can recognize and thank you. Since its inception, many students have taken on the extra challenge to be part of our honors program. Today, we are pleased to celebrate the graduation of 12 students who have completed the requirements of the honors program and who are graduating with all college honors. Students who reach this mark of distinction must complete a series of intensive honors courses and maintain an overall grade point average of 3.4. This year's honors graduates include Holly Brunau, Jacqueline Gamache, Nicholas Gamble, Spring Hajar, Natalie Hughes, Thomas Karras, Corey Mitchell-Labrie, Allison O'Keefe, Kenneth Olchowski, Raylan Sylvester, Danye Smith, and Lindsay Vachon. In addition to completing all the requirements for the College Honors Program, two students also completed the requirements for recognition as Commonwealth Scholars, a statewide distinction. Holly Bruno and Allison O'Keefe are those students. Also, we would like to acknowledge our 2020 MCLA scholars, Holly Bruno, Audrey Birch, Sarah Dunham, TJ Karras, Elizabeth Lesage, Brianna Moran, Meg Richardson, and Paige Williams. An MCLA scholar is a student who has demonstrated significant achievement in independent scholarly work under the supervision of a faculty advisor, shown evidence of professional scholarship, and maintained a minimum GPA of 3.25. In addition to earning their primary degree in an arts or science discipline, candidates who have been enrolled in the undergraduate education program at MCLA also have earned either a second degree in education or have completed the requirements to receive licensure in education. In both cases, the candidates have successfully completed a program designed to meet the requirements for state's approved initial licensure in early childhood, elementary, middle school, or secondary education. Congratulations to all of you. Next, I would like to welcome the chair of MCLA's Board of Trustees in 2020, Denise Marshall. Denise is a 1981 summa cum laude graduate of MCLA and has served as an MCLA trustee since 2012. Denise?
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I would like to welcome everyone to this virtual commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. In this class, MCLA celebrates 382 graduates. I am grateful to have this opportunity to celebrate the significant milestone in your lives. You have all worked hard to get to this point, and it really is worth celebrating. Here are a few statistics about the impressive and diverse class of 2020. Our graduates are highly qualified academically, with 38% having received some type of academic merit scholarship. There are 190 graduates who will graduate with honors. Many of you entered with college credit through dual enrollment courses, AP credits, or international baccalaureate credits. You arrived to MCLA from Massachusetts and New York, as well as 13 other states, including California, Connecticut, Florida, Hawaii, Maryland, Maine, Missouri, New Hampshire, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, and Vermont. Our graduating students are a diverse group, with 22% of the class identifying as Alana students. Also, 49% of you will graduate as the first in your families to have earned a college degree. MCLA is committed to preparing our graduates to be engaged citizens, and you have mirrored that commitment by your involvement in community service, internships, and student government. These leadership development programs have been the foundation to your success at MCLA. On behalf of the MCLA Board of Trustees, I congratulate the 334 of you who have reached the pinnacle of your undergraduate career and the 48 who have successfully attained your graduate degrees, certainly memorable milestones in your lives.
Thank you, Denise. It is now my pleasure to introduce Josie Burlingame, president of the class of 2020. Josie graduated from MCLA in spring 2020 with a bachelor's degree in health science and a minor in biology. She was a proud member of Asian American Union, Women's Lacrosse, and Class Council. She led the class of 2020 for 2 years in a row, being the only class officer during her junior year as treasurer. She then stepped up to become senior class president as she welcomed Vice President Allison Williams and Secretary Carrie Fontana to her team. Josie started her college journey in athletic training program before switching majors her senior year. Although she thoroughly enjoyed her clinical experience with collegiate athletics, she realized that the profession just wasn't for her in the long run. She is currently getting a master's in exercise science with a concentration in strength and conditioning at American International College. She plans to travel and continue working in sports and exercise field as a strength coach. Please join me in welcoming Josie to the podium.
It is never too late to signify our achievements. The MCLA class of 2020 is resilient, hardworking, and wholeheartedly deserving of an authentic celebration. My name is Josie Burlingame, and I am humbled to finally be here. As your class officer, classmate, and friend, I am incredibly grateful to have been on this journey with you. As a group, we grew as one team. Not only did we blaze our own trails, we helped pave the way for others. We became student leaders who were willing, positive, and committed to allyship. We were willing to support one another as we achieved our goals. Even after attending class all day, we put in extra time to attend group sessions, office hours, and tutoring. We ran on Dunkin' Donuts in Tunnel City, spending countless hours printing out notes, essays, and more notes at Freel Library. We survived exhausting exam periods. We committed to jobs and unpaid experience. We volunteered and inspired true change within our communities. On top of that, we were willing to step out of our comfort zone and make time for social activities and find new hobbies. Every small task that we accomplished together has led us to this imperative and exhilarating day. Not only were we persistent, we maintained a positive mental attitude throughout every challenge that we faced. We should keep that same energy as we reflect on our college experience. We were lucky to have caring professors who taught us so much in such a short period of time. We should also appreciate how excited they were to teach, both in person and online. Our advisors and counselors always went out of their way to genuinely help us. we would have our entire day made after one positive interaction with a cafeteria worker. Little moments like those truly were some of the most significant. Some of my favorite memories included just chilling at the Boardman, watching The Bachelor and Bob Ross with a few good friends. We will also never forget shows like Bryce Vine and Pete Davidson. We celebrated Halloween weekends together and were mound bound. There is an endless list of positive memories from our college experience. Continue to focus on the time spent rather than the time lost. The MCLA community might be small, but the people are genuine. We should feel proud to know so many allies around campus. Allyship is not just a leadership skill, but a lifelong commitment. Being an ally means speaking up and uplifting those with less privilege and power than yourself. It takes a lot of listening and the readiness to potentially unlearn and relearn. Continue to pay close attention to the peaceful movements surrounding you. Speak your mind, even when it is uncomfortable. Have real conversations and advocate for inclusion, diversity, and representation. As you continue to embody allyship today, remember that slow progress is still progress. One day, we will be able to celebrate our achievements in person, and it will all be worth it. Stay positive and hopeful. Until then, continue to empower and inspire others with your resilience and optimism. Whether you realize it or not, we are paving the way for future generations. Use what you've learned from MCLA to initiate true change, but never stop exploring. Take risks and let your passions and aspirations guide you through every trail. As Bob Ross once said, there are no mistakes, only happy accidents. Thank you. Next, please join me in welcoming the Masters of Business Administration speaker, Juan Baena. Juan Baena is a higher education professional with 15 years of experience working in the field of advancement. Juan specializes in technology and digital alumni communications at the Williams College Office of Alumni Relations, where he also earned his bachelor's degree in political science with a Latino studies concentration in 2007. Juan is passionate about expanding access and promoting equity and inclusion for underrepresented students in higher education. Juan was born in Columbia and grew up in the New York metropolitan area and has called the Berkshires his home for the past two decades. In his free time, Juan is a freelance photographer and volunteers as a board member at the Williamstown Community Chest. Please welcome Juan.
Recently, I was asked to imagine a window and describe what I saw through it. The first memory that came to mind took me back to my home country of Colombia. The city was Medellin, and I was around 6 years of age. The small window off the front entrance to my home witnessed many evenings where I waited for my father to arrive with his taxi at the end of his shift. Despite my mother's insistence to go to bed early, this curfew was sacrificed at the excitement to see what new toy or sparklers would occupy his tired hands to join my new adventures. Looking past its metal bars, I became ambivalent every night, and sometimes I would pretend I was asleep, only to be awakened by my father's warm embrace as he carried me off to bed. Fast forward to March 9th, 1994. The window is small and reveals a dark, clear sky balanced with vast grids of light below the horizon. If I turn my neck to the right far enough, I could make out the wingspan of the 787 with red stripes and logo that read Avianca. The captain announces that we are soon to land, and my mother fastens my seatbelt. Her face, marked by a look of trepidation for the unknown in a new land, joins my gaze out the window as the airplane turns for its final approach to John F. Kennedy Airport in Queens, New York. You see, there's one less passenger on board. My father had passed away the prior year. At his deathbed, he asked me to look out for her and to become something, get an education. Much like a buried time capsule, the windows into our past, both physical and metaphorical, unearth the peculiarities that define our complicated journeys. When I look back to the window of the past year, I observe the changing of the seasons marked by the colors in the mountains that surround us. I observe the fear and grief unleashed by a global pandemic that brought humanity to its knees. I observe the anger and pain as black and brown bodies ceased to breathe with the heavy weight of racism and xenophobia. I also observe the courage and love from our doctors and nurses on the front lines who spent countless last minutes with loved ones as they perished in isolation. I observe the passion and commitment from those who took to the streets in their local communities as they saw a change for a better future. I observed how the longing for connection made us reassess what was important in life. We are at a tipping point. The challenge ahead cannot be merely addressed as passive bystanders behind our metaphorical windows. What I found empowering over this past few years, as we sat countless hours on Saturdays at Murdoch and Bowman, was the vision our professors instilled within us as transformational leaders going back into a hurting world that needs our help. From navigating leadership styles to understanding the laws of supply and demand, to encoding and decoding communication types, to exploring the notion of corporate social responsibility, it is our imperative to put this knowledge into action as a collective community. The theoretical debate will not be centered as to who is wrong or right, but what is the humane thing to do as we confront our moral compass. Hence, I ask you, fellow classmates, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years from now, what does your window look like? What do you see through it?
Our first honorary degree recipient is Jen Smith. Jen Smith, you have made it your life's work to tell other people's stories. Today, I am proud to share your story. You grew up in Pittsfield, Massachusetts, the adopted daughter of a loving family. In your childhood bedroom, you had a globe where you drew a star marking your birthplace of Kolkata, India. Though you had no memories of this place, you long yearned to travel there. A graduate of the S.I. Newhouse School of Public Communications at Syracuse University, you spent your time writing for many publications before beginning a 15-year career at the Berkshire Eagle, covering education and community, and ultimately serving as community engagement editor. You became well known in the Berkshires for your careful journalistic work, your razor-sharp ethics, and your friendly professional disposition. As a young journalist at the Eagle, you reported from the Berkshires to California, Haiti to Pakistan, and covered crises including the 2013 Boston Marathon bombing, 2012 Sandy Hook Elementary School shooting, 2010 Haiti earthquake, and subsequent community responses. You truly kept the pulse of the Berkshires and honored its residents through your work. Your talent and dedication led you to become a fixture in regional journalism. You served as a regular guest on WAMC Northeast Public Radio's Roundtable and The Media Project, and WTBR 89.7 FM's Good Morning Pittsfield. In 2018, you were MCLA's Hardman Journalist in Residence, offering your expertise and perspective to our students. You have moderated numerous events, regularly volunteered for various community projects and organizations, and visited K through 12 schools and colleges to promote and develop in people media literacy, leadership, and journalism skills. You won many local awards and accolades and recognition for your work and continued to serve the Berkshire community as a member of the Berkshire Leadership Program Steering Committee and worked as a part-time baker at Tunnel City Coffee, rising early to make baked goods for the Northern Berkshire community. As you grew as a regional journalist, you took every opportunity you could to contribute to your field internationally and widen your experience. You are a member of the National Education Writers Association and the Asian American Journalists Association's Seattle chapter. In 2014, you traveled to Pakistan as a fellow with the International Center for Journalists U.S.-Pakistan Professional Partnership Program. You earned journalism scholarships to train with the Poynter Institute, the Hechinger Institute on Education in the Media, and Columbia University. In 2019, you won the Atlas Obscura's inaugural First Journey Travel Contest and got the incredible opportunity to travel to India and explore your birth country. You got to visit the hand-drawn star on your childhood globe and beyond, traveling across India, staying with local families, and taking part in local traditions and activities. After an incredible career in the Berkshires in 2020, you had the opportunity to bring your talents to the Seattle Times Education Lab as its engagement editor. Now, you build community-based networks and work with a team that reports on approaches to some of the most persistent challenges in public education today. You continue to mentor aspiring journalists, examine barriers to economic and social equity, and elevate the stories of people from communities who have been historically underrepresented in or marginalized by media organizations. Jen Smith, for your dedication to community, your inspiring journalism, your adventuresome spirit, and your passion for uncovering the stories that might otherwise remain untold, the Board of Trustees of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Journalism honoris causa.
Trailblazers, congratulations. Today you get to celebrate the anniversary of your 2020 pandemic graduation. I know this is not the stage crossing, cap tossing, magic filled moment you had been waiting a year for. But let me remind you, commencement is not a conclusion. Rather, it marks a beginning. This is the start of something new. As an honorary degree recipient, which I am tremendously grateful for, I can now more accurately say we're in this together. So step into my shoes and let's walk a chapter. Have you ever signed into a Zoom meeting only to find out someone had changed the time? Yeah, that happened to me the other day, but I wasn't alone. A friend of mine had showed up, so we took advantage of what could have been some really awkward airspace to catch up. He shared the sad news that his grandmother had passed away. She had had complications with Alzheimer's disease. In consoling his mother, he encouraged her to hold on to the memories of his grandmother's best moments, not the worst. I guess when it comes to it, we are all just a collection of stories, he said. You and your job, what you do is special in that way. You get to go around and collect all these stories of all our lives, he said. I realized I take this for granted sometimes, how every day I'm given the opportunity to listen and to learn from someone new. Today, I want to encourage you to do the same too. You don't need to be a journalist to do this. You just have to take an open mind, your open heart, and make the time to do it. Why should you do this, you might ask? Why should I care? During this past year, our mortality was challenged in the most profound of ways, as was our desire to be heard. We watched people die of unspeakable sickness and unspeakable violence. We clamored for our votes to be counted, for our lives to matter. We all deserve to feel respected and heard, to have our best moments and our most momentous actions be preciously preserved. Poet Amanda Gorman once described how from our struggles comes our strength. So share your stories and be the keeper of someone else's stories. I'll tell you briefly that I stand before you not as someone who's erected a multi-million dollar building or earned a Nobel Peace Prize, though the latter maybe someday. I am a former journalism student who couldn't afford a computer, who struggled with depression and the pain of being adopted and brown and female in America. But no matter what grief or hell was cast my way, I chose to never let hate or fear tell me who I am and where I can and cannot be. I just want to listen to people, to help people, and do right by my community by making sure their voices are heard. I've learned, finally, I'm enough. And you, you brilliant, resilient, beloved beings are more than enough. You got here today for being your best self, not your worst. Remember that. Graduates, be sure to make it known how you persevered to be here today. And the loved ones listening, whenever you see the special human becoming burnt out and defeated, be sure to bring up the stories of how they came to graduate as evidence of all the glorious things they are capable of. As we listen to each other, we learn and we grow from one another. We grow together. So be sure to listen well and carefully instead of critically. Check your facts and your conscience before you talk about someone else. Repeat history only as a reminder of how we did better or how we can do better. These stories that we share are our lessons and our legacies. So thank you for being here today to listen to me and to all the people who are here to offer you words of advice and congratulations. We say it because we mean it, because we want you to continue to move forward, to climb higher, and to soar to new heights. So go on, take a leap of faith, get into good trouble, and cheers to turning a new page. Congratulations.
Our second honorary degree recipient and commencement speaker is Mary Dana Hinton. Dr. Mary Dana Hinton, you have dedicated your life to empowering others through education. Your lived experience is an example to all that we must pursue what we love, what speaks to us, no matter what advice others give us. Growing up in rural North Carolina in the 1970s and 80s, your mother told you that education was your only way out of poverty. But your high school guidance counselor told you that college was not an option for a Black woman. You knew this was wrong. You went on to attend Williams College, graduating in 1992 with a degree in psychology. You worked for a time as a public school teacher before entering a doctoral program in psychology. You earned a master's degree, but decided a PhD in psychology ultimately wasn't your path. You knew you could make a difference in the world of education and pursued a career in educational policy. The work you did on educational policy, testing different theories in classrooms across the nation, helped create stronger academic programs for students in the United States. You continued this work by helping to open 22 schools in inner city New York and Baltimore. But there was yet another path for you to walk upon. Your liberal arts education had fostered a deep love of learning, which led you to take night classes at Fordham University, including a class in religion. This led you toward a PhD in religion and religious education with high honors from Fordham University and a job as a professor at Misericordia University. From there, you rose in the world of academia and became the president of the College of St. Benedict, an all-women's college in St. Joseph, Minnesota. In your 6 years leading St. Ben's, you put into action a collaborative strategic plan and dynamic vision to guide the institution through 2020. The college completed a $100 million comprehensive fundraising campaign, and you led the process to implement a $43 million campus facilities upgrade. In August 2020, you became the president of Hollins University in Virginia, also an all-women's college returning to the southeastern United States. You wasted no time immediately engaging in dialogue with more than 200 campus community members to create a comprehensive strategy to facilitate and support diversity, equity, and inclusion. This important work was augmented by Hollins' first annual Leading Equity, Diversity, and Justice Day, where more than 550 students, faculty, staff, alumni, and trustees joined together to explore themes of race and racial justice. President Hinton, you also are a member of the Board of Directors for the American Association of Colleges and Universities, Interfaith Youth Corps, St. Mary's School, and the University Leadership Consortium. You also chair the AACNU President's Trust and serve as a member of the Lumina Foundation's Quality Credentials Task Force. In your educational journey, you have continued to empower other leaders who, in your words, grew up in the margins of society. You know that this lived experience growing up in the margins is invaluable for a leader. You are an inspiration to women and girls everywhere, and to men too. A leader who makes space for others, who leads by example, and who knows to trust her own guiding light over others' voices. Dr. Mary Dana Hinton, for your lifetime of accomplishments, your dedication to advancing equity and justice, and for your vast contributions in the field of education, the Board of Trustees of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters honoris causa.
Thank you for your warm welcome and introduction. It is an honor to celebrate with President Burge, the Board of Trustees, the Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts esteemed faculty, staff, and administrators, and of course, the graduates of the class of 2020. What a long, strange journey it has been, but I am delighted to have arrived at this moment with you. Class of 2020, without equivocation, you will have one of the most unique college commencement stories ever. I know that when I accepted President Burge's invitation to speak last year, I could not have predicted that May 16th, 2020 would somehow morph into May 16th, 2021, and that in those intervening 365 days, the world would change so very much. Graduates, when you went home last March, none of us knew what lay ahead. When I reflect on what I wish I knew on those last precious days when we were in our communities, I wish that I had hugged every student, that I had taken photos of every smile, that I had reminded my students that collectively we would get through this year, that we would support one another in our grief, lift one another through our hurt, and hold one another in our hearts. Today, MCLA class of 2020, I want to tell you that you have proven the relevance, resonance, and rewards of MCLA's mission over the past year. Today, I tell you, please never forget that you have, beyond all shadow of a doubt, learned to persist and proven your resilience. In fact, you have proven that the public liberal arts mission of MCLA prepared you to not only excel in the classroom, but in life. Not only in times of comfort and joy, but in times of uncertainty and dismay. After all, when we look back on what has changed over the past year, for me, the list is long. Suddenly, I find my heart beats a little faster when people are within 6 feet of me. Like you, I have had to learn how to see a smile in the eyes of my friends, family, and colleagues, as opposed to focusing solely on the mask covering their faces. Who knew that I could go a year without shopping at the mall, or that I would not miss restaurants while I powerfully miss face-to-face meetings? I could not have imagined that a technology I truly had not heard of on March 15th, 2020, Zoom, would become my daily devotional. Not only have the things around me changed, but I too have changed in the past 12 months. COVID has reminded each of us to recognize the fragility of life and the importance of seizing every moment for the common good. I imagine you, like me, have asked yourself, what do I value? Who do I want and need in my life and my COVID bubble? Have you too reflected on whose hearts you so gently hold even when you cannot be together? I know that our year has certainly helped me to achieve clarity about these most important things. Likewise, I think many of us have also felt emboldened by COVID, as though a veil was pulled back. I believe that many of us have recognized this as a moment to use our voice, our platform, and the fruits of our education. While many of us had ideas about what mattered to us and what we would stand for, the past year has beckoned to us to actually stand up for those things. No longer are our values and commitments merely internalized guideposts. 2020 and 2021 have prompted us to make them real. What has lingered in our hearts and minds is now our vocation. You know, it's very easy and understandable to look back on the prior year and wish for so much to have been different. But because of how things were, you, the class of 2020, had the opportunity to practice what's important, to practice what you learned in the classroom and the residence halls, in late night conversations, and in experiential learning opportunities. Over the past 12 months, you have had the chance to practice what it means to be the beneficiary of a liberal arts education. Here's what I mean. The mission of the Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts states that MCLA promotes excellence in learning and teaching, innovative scholarship, intellectual creativity, public service, applied knowledge, and active and responsible citizenship. It goes on to say, MCLA prepares its graduates to be practical problem solvers and engaged, resilient global citizens. Innovative, creative, service, active and responsible citizenship, problem solvers, engaged, resilient. When we reflect on the past year, despite, or perhaps even because of, the many changes we all endured, these skills are what enabled you to persist and thrive in this uncertain, prolonged, and at times destabilizing moment. In fact, all the things that would have been theoretical for us last year are suddenly very real. You see, despite the many changes we have all experienced this year, there is much that has remained the same. Perhaps the most important parts of our lives are, in fact, unaltered. And that is what I would like to leave you with today. In our intervening year, you were innovative and creative in the ways you identified and met the needs of your family and community. When we look at the many new ways of gathering and being in community, it was powerful thinkers like you that made the past year bearable. As we encountered a national reckoning with racism, injustice, and inequity, it was you, the active and responsible citizens emerging from MCLA, who lifted your voices and your hearts and demanded more from our nation. But most of all, as we made our way through the past 525,600 minutes of the last year, you proved what it means to be resilient global citizens. You now must go out into the world and deploy the skills you so capably demonstrated this year. We know that you can find solutions to the world's most complicated issues. You proved that this year. We know that you have the ingenuity and skill set to build anti-racist and justice-oriented structures. You proved that this year. We know that you have the creative and innovative spirit to make our world more equitable. You proved that this year. You will not be deterred by what the world hands you. Instead, you will rise up and persevere, not only for yourself, but for your families and communities. And yes, you proved that this year. So while there is much we missed during the past 365 days, I hope that you will, most of all, remember the enduring values of the education you received at the Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts. Cherish how those values and our intervening year have equipped you to do more and be more. Let us turn to one another with hope, compassion, and love as we sojourn forth from this moment. Congratulations, graduates. May all good things be yours.
Thank you, Dr. Hinton. As we begin to announce this year's degree candidates, I first would like to acknowledge that this year was anything but usual. We live in a new normal, and I applaud the tremendous grace and resiliency of the class of 2020. By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, through the Department of Higher Education and the Board of Trustees of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts, I am pleased to confer upon those designated candidates who have completed all academic requirements and who have been approved by the faculty the Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study, the degree of Master of Education, the degree of Master of Business and Administration, and Undergraduate Studies, Bachelor of Arts in Performing Arts, Bachelor of Arts in Arts Management, Bachelor of Arts in Art, Bachelor of Arts in English, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Bachelor of Science in Biology, Bachelor of Science in Community Health, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Studies, Bachelor of Science in Athletic Training, Bachelor of Science in Health Sciences, Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, the Bachelor of Arts in Science and Physics, the Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, Bachelor of Science in History and Geography, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, Bachelor of Art in Math, Bachelor of Art in Sociology, Bachelor of Art in Philosophy, the Bachelor of Art in Political Science and Public Policy, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Jessica Abbott, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Nathaniel Abel, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Kara Adams, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Nicole Pelzinski, Master of Business Administration. Wendy Albano, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Zachary Alberita, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Heather Albee, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Andrew Allen, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Danielle Allison, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. William Ames, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Shelley Armstrong, Master of Education. Mackenzie Avalon, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Mariah Baca, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Juan Baena, Master of Business Administration. Carissa Barbosa, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Mitchell Barrett, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Paul Barrett, Bachelor of Arts, History. Rachel Bartlett, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Nicholas Bader, Bachelor of Arts, Physics. Matthew Bellini, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Michaela Bell, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Joseph Bellas, Bachelor of Arts, History. Ryan Belmore, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Daniel Burke, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Alexander Berry, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Emily Bethune, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Emery Bibbins, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Jeffrey Bink, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Nathan Byron, Bachelor of Arts, English. Richley Bissareth, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Ashley Blom, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Dawn Blondin, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Fabienne Bagardas-Street, Bachelor of Arts, English. Kiel Bonilla, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Amanda Botello, Bachelor of Arts, English. Felix Vu, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Heather Boyko, Master of Education. Joseph Brandon, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Abigail Bravo, Master of Business Administration. Giancarlo Bravo, Master of Business Administration. Caitlin Breitenbach, Bachelor of Arts, English. Josh Brilliant, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Heather Berzicki, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Audrey Birch, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Lily Broman, Bachelor of Arts, English. Michaela Brown, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Holly Bruno, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. David Burgess, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Erica Burgess, Bachelor of Science, Math. Josephine Burlingame, Bachelor of Science, Health Science.
My vibe right now is just living life. I am just here to live life.
I was just there living life.
You can't say we didn't live life.
We are definitely living life.
Kevin Burrell, Bachelor of Arts, Philosophy. Samantha Cabral, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Andy Camby, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Samari Cardona, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Elizabeth Carroll, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Olympia Cassavant, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Nicholas Castle, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Laura Sevely, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Michael Chong, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Jessica Christman, Master of Education. Mutita Chumi, Master of Business Administration. Kylan Clark, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Renee Clark, Bachelor of Arts, English. Andrew Clark, Bachelor of Arts, English. Julianne Clark, Bachelor of Arts, English. Katie Cloutier, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Katrina Kluki, Bachelor of Arts, English. Caitlin Cook, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Kara Corlew, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Kristen Crawford, Master of Education. Courtney Cruz, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Tyra Crozier, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Sean Curtis, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Juliana D'Alessio, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Damon Daniel, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Kathleen Darling, Master of Education. Lindsay Darling, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Lauren Davendoni, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jordan DiGaetano, Bachelor of Arts, English. Matthew Delson, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Devin DeLuca, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Megan DeLuca, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. David DeMary, Bachelor of Arts, History. Elizabeth Deneau, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Steve Lynn Desire, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Shannon Desmond, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Sierra Duell, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Isaiah Demanche Silva, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Jacob Dion, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Nicholas DeSanti, Master of Business Administration. Kaylee Donnelly, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Timothy Downs, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Megan Doyle, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Ryan Droth, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Noah Dubois, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Matthew Duffy, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Gina Duggleby, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Abigail Domo, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jessica Dunn, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Sarah Dunham, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Cameron Dunton, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Benjamin Derland, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Connor Duval, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Ryan Dwinnell, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Whitney Eastland, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Emily Edwards, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Paige Ellsworth, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Kabaz Elmelegi, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jessica Emery, Bachelor of Arts, English. Isahaya Ehrlich, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Samantha Falconer, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Cody Faulkner, Bachelor of Science, Athletic Training. Laura Farrington, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Lauren Ferry, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. David Flight, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Timothy Fontaine, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. I know this last year has been a rough one. I want to thank Jeremy, Laura, Michaela, Diane, and Henry for giving me all the tools I need.
Carrie Fontana, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Allison Fortin, Bachelor of Arts, History. Jillian Fournier, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Tanya Frazier, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Madison Frost, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Megan Gage, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jacqueline Gamache, Bachelor of Arts, English. Nicholas Gombardella, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Julie Gamble, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Nicholas Gamble, Bachelor of Arts, English. Austin Godet, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Brady Jarrow, Bachelor of Arts, English. Caitlin Gevry, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Devin Gibbs, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Matthew Gilbert, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Amanda Gilmore, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Kristen Gingras, Master of Education. Tanisha Goines, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Tessa Gonzalez, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Natalie Goodell, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Carolina Gonzalez, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Kimberly Granito, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Sarah Grew, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Samuel Hogg, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Waheed Hage, Master of Business Administration. Spring Hajar, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Andrew Hall, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Barbara Halligan, Master of Education. Duncan Hay, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Megan Haynes, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Gabriel Heinen, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Raphael Heinen, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Brianna Higgins, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Samantha Hines, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Kirsten Hodges, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Sapphire Holland, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Sierra Holland, Master of Business Administration, MBA. Kaylin Holliday, Bachelor of Arts, English. Jennifer Hood, Master of Education. Caitlin Hoftaling, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Paige Howard, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Katie Howe, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. David Howell, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Renee Howell, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Natalie Hughes, Bachelor of Arts, English. Mackenzie Hentoon, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Megan Ireland, Master of Education. Giovanni Jujut, Bachelor of Arts, English. Issa Jallo, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Taylor Jarose, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Theodore Jones, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Lorinda Collegian, Bachelor of Arts, History. T.J. Karras, Bachelor of Arts, English. Alyssa Keegan, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. David Kelly, Bachelor of Science, Physics. Gabrielle Kernozik, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Anthony King, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Elizabeth King, Bachelor of Arts, English. Claire Clammer, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Michael Klein, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Susanna Konecki, Master of Business Administration, MBA. David Kosla, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Amy Kulo Taylor, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies, CAGS. Caitlin Lacoste, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jared LaFountain, Bachelor of Science, Math. Sarah Lafreniere, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Sierra Lamond, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Rowan Lampert, Bachelor of Arts, English. Abigail Luxinski, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Danielle Laureano, Bachelor of Arts, English. Kyla Langston, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Destiny Lawrence Foley, Bachelor of Arts, English. Teresa Leahy, Bachelor of Arts, History. Adelard Lefebvre, Bachelor of Science, Chemistry. Jessica LaSueur, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Daniel Little, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Nia Little, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Andrew Lockman, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Andrew Rose Long, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Yashia Love, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Science. Catherine Lovett, Master of Business Administration. Keen Lund, Bachelor of Arts, Philosophy. Mohamed Maris, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Dominic Maiello, Bachelor of Arts, History. Rishana Main, Bachelor of Arts, Physics. Philip Malm, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Wayne Maloney, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Rachel Mancor, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Alexandra Manello, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Lise Mansere, Bachelor of Arts, English. Kate Maroney, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Howard Marshall, Master of Education. Audrey McDonald, Bachelor of Arts, Philosophy. Andre Martin, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Madison Mayer, Bachelor of Arts, English. Caitlin Mays, Bachelor of Arts, English. Maya McFadden, Bachelor of Arts, English. Megan McGinley, Bachelor of Arts, English. Casey McKeever, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Courtney McKeever, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Ryan McMahon, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Matthew McKinney, Bachelor of Arts, English. Ashley McLaughlin, Master of Education.
I just wanted to say thanks, Mom and Dad. It's a year later and I'm still celebrating, and that's because of the both of you. I love you.
Audra McMahon, Graduate Certificate in Business Administration. Michaela McMahon, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Iris McPherson, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Riley Mead, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Amanda Mechiwar, Graduate Certificate in Business Administration. Ryan Meehan, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Stephanie Melito, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Matthew Merritt, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Daniel Munier, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Kristen Merrick, Master of Business Administration. Benjamin Michener, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Caitlin Millard, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Wyatt Nino, Bachelor of Arts, English. Alexander Mitchell, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Clarissa Mitchell, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Sarah Mitchell, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Corey Mitchell Labrie, Bachelor of Arts, English. Keyshawn Monroe, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Brianna Moran, Bachelor of Science, Biology. John Morrissey, Bachelor of Arts, English. Alexis Nason, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Nevada Nelson, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Kathleen Nielsen, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Caroline Noonan, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Emma Nordby, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Sarah Ogden, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Oganamarho Ajulo, Bachelor of Arts, English. Allison Oki, Bachelor of Arts, English. Kenneth Olkowski, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jacob Oliveira, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Jordan Oliveira, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Edwina Opoku, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Drew Pear, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Nicole Patry, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Simone Patron Lozoff, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jordan Paul, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Hunter Phillips, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Hannah Pimenta, Bachelor of Arts, English. Ryan Sutka, Bachelor of Arts, History. Sophia Player, Bachelor of Arts, English. Brittany Polito, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Lyudmila Polo-Tai, Master of Education. Brittany Potter, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Danielle Prestigomo, Bachelor of Arts, Art Management. Erica Quackenbush, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jack Quatrochi, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Tashari Rainwater, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Mohammed Rashid, Master of Business Administration. Doriana Reardon, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Colin Ricor, Bachelor of Science, Athletic Training. Alyssa Reddy, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Victoria Reese, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Michael Reagan, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Scott Rehm, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Kaylee Reinhard, Master of Education. Bielka Reynoso, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Hans Resignac, Bachelor of Arts, Communications. Erica Rue, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Christopher Reyes, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Allison Rice, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Ellen Richardson, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Megan Taylor Richardson, Bachelor of Science, Math. Chayla Rodriguez, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Justin Ruffley, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Hannah Roy, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Logan Rumbold, Bachelor of Arts, Physics. Caitlin Ryan, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Elizabeth Sachs, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Ayana Samuel, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Molly Sains, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Natalie Sanford, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Marilyn Saunders, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Samantha Scaccia, Master of Business Administration. Bradley Scanlon, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Lily Schaub, Bachelor of Arts, English. Auguste Scheid, Master of Business Administration. Timothy Schmidt, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jade Schnauber, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Hunter Schrade, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Samantha Schwantner, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Melanie Sayaba, Bachelor of Science, Education. Christian Syriac, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Ryan Senecal, Master of Business Administration. Tessa Sestito, Bachelor of Arts, English. Alex Tershand, Bachelor of Arts, English. Nicole Shepherd, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Kelsey Sherman, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Richard Shoup, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Zachary Ciano, Bachelor of Arts, History. Raylan Sylvester, Bachelor of Arts, English. Nicholas Simeoni, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Chelsea Simmons, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Kaya Small, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jaisa Smith, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Don G. Smith, Bachelor of Arts, English. Hannah Snell, Bachelor of Arts, English. Parker Snyder, Bachelor of Arts, English. Zipporah Solis, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Chloe Solomon, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Zachary Sandrini, Master of Education. Hannah Sorensen, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Brianna Susi, Bachelor of Science, Radiologic Sciences. Nicholas Spanswick, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies, CAGS. Kevin Speech, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Jillian St. John, Master of Business Administration. Michael Steben, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Dominique Stevenson Pope, Bachelor of Arts, History. Isaac Stewart, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Demetria Sweener, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Molly Sweet, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Michael Swint, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Madison Tabor, Bachelor of Arts, English. Kayla Targic, Master of Education. Leslie Tay, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Akira Taylor, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Julia Teixeira, Bachelor of Arts, English. Nadia Tenorio, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Rachel Terlizzi, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Benjamin Testa, Bachelor of Arts, English. Allison Therian, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jack Therian, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Aliasia Thomas, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Rebecca Thomason, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Georgia Thompson, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Emily Thurston, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jillian Teetkins, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Joseph Toledo, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Veronica Torres Martin, Master of Business Administration. Lisa Torrey, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Natalie Torrey, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Cassandra Tournier, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Sarah Trova, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Julia Turner, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Macy Terrell, Bachelor of Arts, Art. Cassandra Ulrich, Bachelor of Science, Business Administration. Lindsay Vachon, Bachelor of Arts, English. Jacob Valenti, Bachelor of Arts, English. Hannah Vanda Water, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Krista Vancor, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Brian Vega, Bachelor of Arts, Political Science. Gianna Vigliatura, Bachelor of Arts, English. Jacob Vitali, Bachelor of Arts, Communications. Lisa Wolf, Master of Business Administration. Kayla Walker, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Rosalie Walter, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies. Kylan Warren, Bachelor of Arts, English. Robert Weary, Bachelor of Arts, English. Brialyn Wells, Bachelor of Arts, Sociology. Jessica Wheeler, Master of Education. Samantha White, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Allison Riley Williams, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Paige Williams, Bachelor of Science, Biology. Ashley Wilson, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Carol Wilson, Bachelor of Arts, Interdisciplinary Studies. Melanie Wilson, Master of Education. Kendall Winston, Master of Education. Jessica Wojcik, Master of Business Administration. Corey Woodley Ajay, Bachelor of Arts, Performing Arts. Killeen Wright, Bachelor of Arts, English. Jordan Young, Bachelor of Science, Health Science. Ava Zygmunt, Bachelor of Science, Environmental Studies.
The Greek philosopher Heraclitus suggests that the only permanence in life is change. If that thinking is true, you, the class of 2020, are very different people today than when you arrived at MCLA. It is the case that you now have a developing expertise in an academic discipline that you did not have 4 years ago. You've discovered the importance of others' ways of thinking that have challenged and perhaps changed your own thought patterns. Some of you arrived as business majors and are leaving as artists, while others who dreamed of becoming a teacher discovered the complexities of our educational system and are ready and prepared to enhance its quality. Some of you discovered an inner leader that allowed you to become president of the Student Government Association or captain of your athletic team. All of you have changed in one way or another, which is exactly what a liberal arts education should accomplish. You are now ready to learn even more about yourselves, your careers, and the world. It is also the case that the world is a different place today than it was when you arrived here. There is a pressing need in our world today for thoughtful, intelligent, creative people. The world and our communities are calling for more MCLA graduates to ameliorate the conditions that have become so oppressive and so dangerous for so many. Use your education, your knowledge, to create change while bringing more kindness into the world. As the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King said, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. Fortunate for our world, you have been educated well by my colleagues at MCLA. You know how to identify and solve problems. You are skilled at working with groups of people to advance improvement. You are practiced in the art of knowing where to find beauty and how to help others find their own truth. Having been raised in the digital age, you know how to apply technology to solve problems, and you understand the importance of serving one's community. Let me reinforce what I just said. We educate people to help advance society. We educate people to discover beauty and truth. We educate people to use technology. We educate people to be public servants. We educate students not just so that they have a better life, but so that we all have a better life. Could there be a more noble mission for higher education? This is our compact with society that makes higher education the most important social institution in our nation, and because of that, public higher education should be supported more fully. As graduates of MCLA, you are a promise we make to the world to honor the centuries-old purpose of American higher education, which is to respond to the needs and demands of society. You are the best hope and strategy we have to improve this broken world. And so this is my charge. The motto of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts is Lux Esto Vera, in light there is truth. MCLA has lighted the lantern of truth in you. Use this light, this truth, to reveal what you can do to improve the world for us all. To the members of the class of 2020, you are now graduates of Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts. Please move the tassel on your mortarboard from right to left. Upon conclusion of these commencement exercises, if you are able, please join us for the farewell Zoom call to gather one last time. These 121st commencement exercises are now concluded. Please join me in congratulating the class of 2020.